Hello everyone, so welcome back to this channel once again, and in this video session I'll discuss job D for jobs in ASP.NET. So basically job D is job description, and we will discuss about this job description here in this video. So let's start with the introduction of job D. So job D basically holds the information for a particular job, that how the job runs on a system, IBM system. So basically it controls the job flow. So let's say it basically have the information about all these things, that is job queue, to be used at the job. Job queue is something where the job which will get submitted, the priority of the job, that is the scheduling priority when the job is active, routing data if any, a message queue severity, what should be the message queue severity, with a 30 40 20, that depends. A libelous information, so this is the most important thing which I would mention here as a note as well, that job D basically controls the access of libelous by the job. So libelous information is holded by the job D. So let's say if you submitted a job using the submit job, and you provided the job D information there, so you provided the job D value there on the submitted job, then whatever the libelous set up in the job D will be used by the job instead of the libraries which are set up in your session from where you submitted your job. So the other information would be like output information, where the output will go. So all this information would be held by the job D, job description of a job. So basically it is more significant for the job. So this was the introduction of this job D. Now there is a command. Now how we'll create the job D? So there is a command, create job D. I cannot demo here, but because I don't have authority with my user profile. So for creating a job D, you need to run the command create job D from IBM I. There we have several things like okay, now let's move on to the submit job command. So here you see, you'll notice that I can mention the command which I want to execute, job name, job description. So this is job description. The default setup for me is the user profile. So whatever the job D associated with the user profile would be used here. Okay. And if I want, I can name it. Okay. If I want, I can name it. Job description name I can provide. Or let's see what job D associated with me. So I just say that job D name is easy class, which is there in the QGPL. So let's see what it has. DSP job D easy class. So user profile RQD, CL syntax, and security is 30, job date, job switches, inquiry message apply, job priority is 5 on job queue. Job queue used will be easy class, so which is present in QGPL. So job queue which is used is this one, output priority is 5. Output queue is based upon the user profile, whatever the user profile out queue, that is the class again. Message logging level is set to 40 star sec LVL. So in this case, and log CL programs command is star yes, which means the job log will be generated for every job being submitted. Requesting data is QCMDI. So all these things are set up here with this user profile, with this job D related with the user profile. There is one more value which we can provide here is QDFT job D. Let's see where it is. It's available in the job description. It's available in the QGP default. It's a default job description. So if you do DSP job D for this one, you will see the setup for this. It's the default batch job queue is queue batch. So whenever we pass this value, the job went to the queue batch job queue, and these are the priorities for the job queue or the output queue for this job. This is the message logging level, which is same. Again, other things are related with the user profile. You can see other things as well from here. So these are all information which you can have a look for the job D. So whatever the possible values you can provide is either this one, QDFT job D, job description name, or either you can specify star user profile as well. Possible value of the job D library is star IBL. So for job D library, you can provide these three values: star IBL, star curlib, library name. Star IBL means whatever the library list is set currently in your session will be used to look for the job D object, and star currently will be basically your current library which is set in the session, so that would be used to search for the job D. Library name, so if you specify the library name, so in that only that library your job D will be searched. So all these things are here in this video. So we basically discussed about job description. So let's see, let's submit a job. Call PGM1. This one. So let's to job D. Job queue is associated with the job D. So the job D, job key associated with this job D is queue batch. Job priority. Let me check whether it allows me to run in this job description or not, because I don't have such authorities. But let me try. I'll do all the things are related with the job D's. So let's job D's. Hold star yes. So it's submitted basically. So you can see when I provided the queue default job D description, the job has been submitted. The same name job has been submitted. This is the user profile name. This is the job number being allocated. Submitted to job queue batch. So with this job D queue batch, job queue was associated in library QGPL. So you can see for queue the job. So the job is currently on hold. So this was the earlier job which is on hold. Let's release this. This is completed. And let's release this as well. Okay, now let's submit a job for instead of this, let's use a profile. So you can see this time this easy class user profile job D has been used, because we submitted in the same job, we passed the same job D, and job Q easy class in library just take F1 in QGPL is being used. So this way you got how this actually works. Just to work user job, this is on hold, so let's release using option 6. So this way you got the idea of the job D, how it is used by the job. So that's all. Thank you. And